What's the most disturbing secret you are keeping from your friends and family? I have stage 4 breast cancer and a prognosis of stable. I could be here for years and years. Doing my treatment and living my life. Not secret. I don't want to be a cancer patient for years and years. My treatment sucks and it makes me feel sick every day. My brain sucks due to chemo. There are some real cognitive difficulties. I had to give up a career I loved. I'm entry-level call center from home now. I've been home, not going out to fun places, since March of 2020. Because my immune system sucks. It's worth the risk to go to the doctor or my son's parent-teacher conference. But not the bar. My secret is that every time I make a wish, I wish for the cancer to kill me faster. This existence, feeling like garbage and doing my call center thing so I can afford to feel like garbage, is disheartening and it sucks. I'm in therapy and an exercise program and I have hobbies. I'm doing what I can to keep slogging along. But damn, the I don't wanna is strong sometimes. Edit. Thank you all so much for the love and support. I'm reading every comment, but can't answer them all. Because phone room, it's not my first choice but I'm determined to do well. And that means being ready and grabbing those calls. I truly appreciate your compassion. Mom believes my dad hired a private investigator and that that's who caught her cheating on him. It wasn't a PI. In reality, I was the one who caught her on video and completely by chance. She'd come for blood if she was ever told the truth. Edit. Damn. I really didn't think this would get that much attention. Thanks for all the messages and kind words being thrown my way. I really don't feel worthy. Full story. That I'm the happiest I've been in my adult life without my family. Still depressed. But mental healing takes time. Edit. Holy crap. 10 years on Reddit and never had a comment or post blow up like this. Thanks for the awards and comments of support, everyone. May we all find the peace we seek walking our own path. That my uncle showed me how to use a vibrator when I was 5. I can't even bring it up in therapy. I should clarify. The vibrator was a neck massager, but he most definitely showed me where to put it. I said it tickled and he said keep it there. Update. Wow. Thank you. Every single one of you for sharing your thoughts, concerns, and personal stories. For years I never even considered this saw even though I knew it made me feel shame. I'd be horrified if this happened to any of my kids but it just didn't register. I'm still not ready to share in therapy. Mostly because I'm in it with my husband. As for my uncle, he's the loser in the family. Unsuccessful in every aspect. So that part of me feels like he's getting what he deserves. My sister used to kiss me with tongues and cuddle me weirdly, and now as an adult thinking back to that I realize that was super fucking weird for her to do since we're 13 years apart. At minimum she would have been 20 when that happened and I would have been 7 at least. Nothing else happened so maybe it was innocent stuff but IDK. If I was 20 and made out with a 7-year-old sister I'd be in fucking prison. Not so much disturbing. But I absolutely never want them to find out that I am the one in the family who draws little smiley faces in random spots for everyone to find. Everyone always accuses each other and of course I play along. But I am the one who does it lol. My second tour in Iraq we were in a nasty firefight when I felt something wet hit the side of my face. I knew the guy next to me had been killed but I was a little too busy to do anything about it. After it was done the corpsman came running over making sure I was okay. And I thought it was because I was covered in the guy's blood. Turns out one of the guy's eyes was basically dangling on the side of my helmet. I would almost certainly have killed myself if it wasn't for the fact that they'd be unable to handle it. I also pushed a candle up my ass as a teenager to see if I liked it. Edit. The sensation did nothing for me and I can confirm that candle was, mercifully, unlit. I banged one of my mom's friends after mowing her yard. Edit. My most upvoted comment is about sex. My mom molested me for 5 years, from ages 4 to 9. She manipulated my whole family for them to believe I am crazy to discredit me if I were to ever come out with the truth. Then, she paid me $10. $000 to not tell anyone. All I did with the money was buy heavy drugs to numb the pain. I've moved across the country to get away. My whole family hates me. Edit. Thank you for all the kindness. It is very much appreciated. For those telling me they've gone through this too. I am so sorry. At least we have camaraderie in one another. I suppose. One day I woke up after a very manipulating relationship had ended and realized I didn't know how to feel anything but anger. I never really feel happy. Or sad. Let alone cry. I'm never excited for anything. People have died and I just can't seem to feel anything. I put on a great face. Can fake most of my emotions. But deep down I don't really feel anything positive or negative besides anger. The more I type, the more I realize I don't even know how to put it all into words. And #x200b. Edit. I did not expect this to blow up like this, holy crap lol. Thank you everyone for the kind words. It's been about 12 years now since that happened. I will try and reply when I can. I will definitely be taking some of these suggestions, so thank you everyone who took the time to respond. This is something sad and a bit NSFW. When my abusive stepdad was around, he would molest me and brother. We were his stepkids. He tried to make us do things to each other in front of him once. I ran and locked myself in the bathroom and threatened not to come out until mom got home from the gym. He coaxed me out and never tried again. I learned that he was scarred of my mom because she had military training and he tried to hit her once. She grabbed his hand and threatened to kill him if he did or hurt us. She never knew he did anything to us because he was a master manipulator. To add, he got arrested because I told and got 50 years. Edit. For those who want to know how mom didn't know, he had calculated mom's movements. Like when she got off work. If she had to do shopping. And would make her get stuff from the store. All to plan his little sick mind. He was good at this. And I luckily stopped it before he went to my other little siblings. I am glad that they are safe now. About $40,000 in debt. That I want to pick up and move and start over alone, with my dogs, with zero trace. That an older kid fucked my ass when I was 6 years old. But I don't really give a fuck about it being a secret or not anymore. The people I was hiding it from was my dad and my mother. My mother died and my dad is a prick and I don't give a fuck about what he thinks. That when I was in middle school I was groomed by an online predator I met on Omegle. Being a stupid child at the time. I innocently believed I was talking to someone my age and should have seen the red flags when they kept making excuses on why they couldn't send pics or video chat or talk on the phone for that matter, but had no problem texting and asking me for explicit pictures of myself. My cousin that is 7 years older than me, and I had never met before then, told me that boys his age, 14 at the time, needed to experiment with women and that I should let him learn and not tell anyone. That I was sexually abused by a family member as a child. Just recently opened up about it to my therapist. Tough going. Edit. Blown away by all the support. Thank you all so much. I cry almost daily because I'm so fucking lonely. Being the oldest of the cousins and knowing the real family history and secrets. I'd rather let them enjoy life without knowing. My friends and family don't use Reddit. So no throwaway necessary. Sometimes. I am passively suicidal. I am so fucking tired of being alive. But I don't want to kill myself. 1. I'm afraid of what happens or doesn't happen after you die too. I don't want to hurt them like that. Even if I am in a lot of pain. 3. There's still some things I want to do. Even though I do feel fucking worthless, ugly, exhausted. As you can imagine, I don't really have anyone to talk about it with. And I don't want to worry the people I love. It's a battle sometimes. Edit. I'm gonna cry. You guys. I really didn't anticipate all the attention, support this comment got. Thank you so much. I can't imagine the future. People ask me what my plans are and I just don't know. I have no chance of making plans. There's just no vision or hope or amount of wishing hard enough to try and plan or predict my own future. I'd rather be dead than have to try to think about where I'll be in 5 years. My aunt is my sister. That I've had a major increase in suicidal thoughts lately, not going to act on them but just noticed a major increase. I was 9 and was sexually assaulted. I know my dad didn't do it cause he had a broken back and could barely walk around the house, so no way he could walk up the stairs, they were very very steep. So I don't know who did it and none of my family knows and they never will. I've thought about telling my sister but I don't know. It's something that I'm embarrassed by and it makes me feel like I'm less of a man. Edit. I took some of the advice from these comments and opened up to my sister about it cause I know she has a similar experience. Talked for damn near an hour and just told her everything about what I had been feeling. So I'm so forth. But to be honest, I might not tell anyone else in my family cause I guess I just don't really know who did it and there's no way to prove who did it. I guess that just makes it easier on my mind and makes it easier to coop. I probably didn't spell that right. But thank you to everyone who at least tried to help. I didn't even expect any of this. I appreciate y'all more than you could ever possibly know. When I was 10 to 11 years old and family friend, 28Y at that time, sexually assaulted me. Haven't told anyone. Where, my family, still in close contact with him and he's married now and has a child. It feels weird sometimes to see him with his own little family. Edit. Thank you all for your kind words. I will seek out help when I'm ready for it. To the people telling me to expose him. I know you guys are probably right and I told myself I will if I ever notice anything weird again. Be it his behavior towards me or anyone else. I escorted for years, including my junior and senior years of high school, to pay for college. So many times I would be at a friend's doing schoolwork, but I was with a client or a few times I told them I was going out of town for the weekend as part of a school club trip when I was actually being flown to different cities by much older men for the weekend. I even typed up a bullshit permission slip and everything. BTW, I am aware of how dangerous that was. I do not need a lecture. They think I took out student loans and am still paying them off to this day. I was able to pay for all 4 years by the time I graduated. The only reason I am still here today is because I forgot to load a round into the chamber of my pistol when I was 18. I pulled the trigger, but thankfully all the rounds were in the clip. It was a huge wake-up call. I am doing a lot better now. Sometimes I pretend to be happy around them. I was raped at age 14. Spiked drink at a house party. Woke up naked and bloody in a spare bedroom. Vague memories of a body on me and pain but couldn't move. Just slightly aware mentally. Never told anyone until #MeToo forced me to deal. Still haven't told my family or most friends. Still don't like to be touched. 50-50 I panic attack and flashback while sexually with a partner. Edit. Thanks friends. In therapy. Haven't had any episodes with my last two partners over the past 3 years. I sometimes eat dessert before dinner. I've been selling weed for the last 8 years to supplement my income. Life's been really great during COVID. Terminal illness. Chances are I have less than 10 years, but it could be tomorrow. No cure. No chance of recovery. There may be a point before too long where I am unable to hide it, but some of them are old so might pass before that happens. I am happy to keep it quiet for their peace of mind as long as possible. Dunno if it counts as a disturbing secret, but I am more upset about the slack in expectations on me now than I am about my brother's death. Maintaining a relationship with them feels like a job. We weren't close when I was young and now they want to be super close. Maybe to make up for lost time? But I got used to being left alone so now I prefer it that way. My, almost, ex-husband's mom introduced me to meth. And even though I hated it, I kept doing it because I worked 80-hour weeks trying to keep our family afloat during the pandemic, husband wasn't working. By choice. I hated myself so much. And I hated that I was doing it. But I loved being able to stay awake to do whatever was needing to be done. This went on for about a year. Eventually found out he was cheating on me for a long while. Kicked him out. And got together with someone else. He unknowingly got me clean. I've been clean for about 14 months now and it makes me sick to even type this shit out. The worst choices I've ever made. By far. I lost my virginity when I was raped at 14. My mother was out working and my father was out either cheating on my mom and playing billiards or pool or whatever you call it. I invited my adult boyfriend over, this seemed normal to me at the time. I told him I didn't want to do anything sexual. When he insisted I told him. Very clearly. No, but he forced himself on me. I tried to fight back, but he was a very strong man. After he just stopped talking to me. And so did I. IDK. I feel so dirty sometimes. Edit. Thank you everyone for the kind comments. At the time, I didn't want to report it because I didn't want to out myself as gay. And because I was extremely embarrassed. Now, it's on my mind constantly that I should report him. That my mental health is collapsing again. I'm failing uni again. And I'm going into debt to stay afloat again. Thinking about becoming a drug dealer or killing myself before the year is out because those are the only options left. But don't know if I can do that to my cancer-diagnosed mom. Edit. I'd like to thank everyone for their kind words. Didn't really expect anything when I posted this. It means a lot. Less than 3. Most days I feel like I don't know who I am. I was diagnosed with severe anxiety and depression around 15 years old. I feel like I never got to develop a personality. I've never been able to hold down a job for more than a few months due to my mental health. Sometimes I feel okay, but most of the time I just feel like 3 mental illnesses in a trench coat trying to find my way through life. I have a porn addiction, but I'm slowly beating it. Edit. Pun not intended. Might not be incredibly disturbing, but it's a secret. I've hated and doubted my family's religion for 5 years straight. I'm Mormon. Not gonna go into greater detail cause I am already getting paranoid just saying that. You are constantly worrying that one of your friends will tell your parents. Or one of your teachers. I can't even tell half of my IRL friends because they are part of the church and I can assure you they will tell somebody. And I'll be forced to go to some sort of faith class. Basically, Mormon rehab for people who doubt the church. And yes, I'm not even exaggerating. Look it up. My aging mother is battling cancer. She isn't winning. She has asked me to be power of attorney and the executor of her estate. While going through her legal papers, I came across the documents that showed that my sister, we are both in our 50s, is actually only my half-sister. She has a different father. My mom never told anyone. My father has been gone for almost 20 years. And he never said anything either. He stepped up when the real father took off. This was in the 1960s. My sister doesn't know. I actually hate them and feel no love for them, but I feel obligated to be a good family member. Also, they would all probably kill each other without my good vibes to settle everyone down. I'm the middle child and kinda like Kevin McAllister from Home Alone. Was constantly shit on by every member of my family. I was the scapegoat. I was the problem. I was the issue. FML. Nice try, FBI. One of them is a rapist. My stepmother is making my dad take antidepressants without him knowing. She lies about it and tells him it's cholesterol meds. She does this BC she likes my dad better when he's on them. But he doesn't want to take them. Her and I are the only people that know. I've been contemplating about calling the cops on her. She brutally kicked me out the house about a month ago. She's a mischievous bitch and will get my ass sued. I know I should report her. But I'm terrified, y'all. My ass, but mostly my brain, is autistic. Family legend. My grandfather and grandmother fell in love at first sight and courted one another for years before getting married. Reality. They met when my grandfather was on a 2-day pass. Fell in love at first sight. And were married by the end of the weekend. Both corroborated this story in separate private interviews I conducted when compiling family history. That I quit college. This is a huge deal. Since I was in college for 3 years. And now every day is beyond terrifying to me because with each passing day my future is getting closer and I don't know if it's gonna be okay. I fantasize about murder constantly. I go to therapists and psychiatrists, started recently. But I have these thoughts ever since I was a kid. I have never killed any animals, I love them and could never. And I don't plan on killing anyone for the simple fact that I don't want to go to prison. I keep making violent drawings and I tell everyone it's just inspired on horror movies and games that I enjoy. But the truth is that I'm venting the daily images from inside my head. I have a normal life. Not many friends, but simply because I'm not interested in making any. I have a girlfriend whom I love very much. And my older brother that always makes me laugh. A job with some good people. And I go to college. But when I'm alone, at my head, I've killed everyone in the nastiest way ever. That I took my, now ex-girlfriend to get an abortion. She wanted to keep it. But I was in a downward spiral in life soaked in drug abuse. I couldn't even think about having a child in that moment. As I could barely take care of myself. She eventually agreed. But I know deep down that she wanted to keep it. We broke up a couple of weeks later after the abortion. As she couldn't even look at me anymore. It's been 5 years since then. And I still hate myself every single day because of it. I wonder what that child would have been like. And if I ever would have been able to take care of them. Also, the abortion clinic was under renovation at the time we arrived. So they moved the clinic into the maternity ward at the hospital. My girlfriend was taken away for the procedure. And I was left sitting in the waiting room holding back tears. A man sat down next to me and said, "I know it's scary, man. But it'll be the best moment of your life. My wife is in labor right now." Quote dot. Later on, the same man and his wife were being moved to another room, as she had just had her baby. My girlfriend had just come out at the same time, and was under a heavy amount of pain medication. She saw the newborn baby and said, "They just had a baby. And I just killed one." I hear that sentence every single day. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop a like. If you would like to see more content like this in the future, subscribe and turn on notifications to be notified about future videos. Now check out one of these interesting videos.